Well, hello there guys, Qwerty Afro here with another Transport Fever video for you guys. Today, I think it's about time we start doing a free custom game, because the campaign is sort of okay. It's alright, it's a bit plain, it's a bit one-sided, there's not really much to do, it's just really specific little tasks to do in certain like areas with certain types of transportation, so there's not a lot of variety and it kind of gets a little bit boring. I will be continuing the campaign though, I want to finish the European campaign. I've already think I have 2 or 3 videos of the next mission recorded, and I will be continuing that on a slower process, and then maybe if like by the end game of the campaign it's good, I might go on to the USA campaign, but we'll see. But today I really want to start a free custom game. I want to bump up the years a bit and start like in 1950, so we can start getting some of the more modern transportation kind of vehicle types, which you guys I think would want to see. There is actually a mod that can actually unlock, so once you have a vehicle type that's unlocked, it will stay unlocked forever, instead of normally what would happen in the game is a vehicle type would unlock and then after a certain time, like say a steam train will disappear once it passes a certain age. It's like, I think with the preview build there's just one mod where you can have everything unlocked, so once it's unlocked forever, so I'm gonna have that unlocked for you guys, and I can't wait till when the game is released and then we have more mods on the Steam Workshop and it'll get nitty-gritty. I'm enjoying this game and the opportunities and stuff that actually await it once it does get released and, like, you know, modding does become a thing. Let's get into this. The shoutouts for this video go to Morgan Burge and Callum O'Connor's stuff. That's again Morgan Burge and Callum O'Connor's stuff. Their links and stuff will be down below. Please show them stuff. Those are the shoutouts. So we would go here onto the free game, and then you can choose here between a custom, like what scenario would you want? Do you want Europe, USA custom? And I'm guessing once the Steam Workshop becomes like a thing, you'll be able to pick more scenarios where people can like make certain types of maps, I assume. I'm not too sure. If you go here into the advanced tab, you can see this is what the mods that you can get. I've gotten the vehicles no end year, so it basically means that modifies vehicles availability such that once a vehicle becomes available, it will remain available for the rest of the game. So that I'm gonna keep on so we can use some of the older vehicles, obviously, because I haven't really played a lot through these kind of older periods. I want to at least have all the older period vehicles available for me so we can even use them in the modern setting. It doesn't really matter, we could have some heritage lines or something like that, you know, things are endless. There is also this no cost ability, which I was thinking, do I want to do something on unlimited, but that I still want that kind of money, kind of, you know, that kind of finance option there where we don't have to go too ham on everything. Yeah, I could easily pick no cost and just build everything that I want to build straight away in the first episode, but I don't want to do that. I want to build this up as a nice little kind of thing on this first ever kind of free custom map that I'm going to do for you guys. I haven't actually played a custom game yet. This is my first time doing it. I've only been testing out in the campaigns, really, not actually looking into this kind of free custom stuff. So this is my first time really going into it. So I think I'm going to keep the no-cost mod, you know, behind bars a bit now. Maybe once the game comes out, there's more mods available. We'll see what we can do. But for now, I think the vehicles no end year is the best one to actually have for us. And then here, we're in the advanced setting. You can change how you want things. So we can basically have a European terrain and have American vehicles, or vice versa. Town names, I'm going to keep on. You can have Korean town names. That is brilliant. I'm actually tempted. Should we have some Korean town? No, let's have English town names. Well, most of my subscribers are English, so I'm gonna do some English town names. But I definitely want to do, like, that'd be so cool. Like, if someone in the future makes like something like a Korean map or whatever, or Korean terrain, and then just make some. Yeah, oh, that'd be great. But I was tempted there with the Korean. So yeah, you can do European terrain or American terrain, whatnot. Trees, European American. Buildings, European American. Streets, European American. Environment, European American. Scenario, European American. Really, I'm tempted to put the trees as American, or maybe I should keep it on Europe. I'm not too sure, but I don't want to change it. Like, I don't want American vehicles. I don't want American terrain. Maybe no, because I'm doing it in England. It'd be better to just keep it on European terrain. But I don't know if there's anything else I really want to change to American, just to kind of maybe spice it up a bit. I'm not too sure. Streets, buildings. I'm tempted to just leave the trees on American, but I don't know what's too different about American trees compared to European trees. I don't know. That's a toughie. I'm gonna just keep it. You know what? Let's go for it. Let's go for American trees. Just out of the way. I don't want to change anything else. Let's just make it a little bit funky here because we're changing up a bit with the vehicles, no NDM mod and whatever. Let's change something. Let's not keep it all European, but American trees in a European setting. Let's go for it. So if we save that, and then we have a world size here. I'm gonna go on the largest here. And then you have a world format where you can set the side lengths to a 1-to-1 ratio, a 1-to-2 ratio, or 1-to-3 ratio. I think 1-to-1 is the biggest one, so that's like huge, and I think I've tested it out. It's like, wow, when I loaded up into it just when I was testing it, it's huge. And I think I'm gonna keep it that. I'm gonna keep it on the 1-to-1. I want to go the largest. I'm gonna show you guys what we're dealing with here. I think the map is huge. What we get here that's kind of fogged out is the select map. I'm guessing that's going to be for when Steam Workshop, when modded maps and stuff come in, where you can select a particular map that you want, or particular terrain type that you want, or whatever, something like that, I'm assuming. So we have a terrain type of either flat, medium, or hilly. I'm going to go with medium. I don't think we need, like, flat would just be too boring. And hilly might be a bit too expensive because obviously we're going to be starting with money anyway. So I'd keep it medium. That's fine. Now the starting year is the one where I'm definitely bumping up to the latest one, so we can get those newer vehicles in as soon as possible. You can also select a custom date where we can even go to 1990. But I'm fine with starting in 1950. That's too. We're not in a rush to get all the modern vehicles. I just don't want to start at 1850 and have to work through the 90s and then beginning of the 20th century. I'd rather start somewhere in the middle of the 20th century. That for me works out perfectly. Then difficulty. I'm gonna keep. You can win, you'll be challenged. I'm gonna go in easy. I've seen some other videos and whatnot that, like, on medium you do not get as much money as on easy. I'm gonna keep it on easy so we just have enough money to start out with, and it'll still be a challenge because we're gonna be spending money and having to make up money to keep in the green, basically. So I'm gonna keep it in easy just to make it, so basically to compensate for not taking the no cost money mod. So I guess that's fair enough. And then you have a seed, which you can just randomize to your heart's content. I don't know what each of these things would do, but it just basically randomizes the whole map itself. So once I have fun just clicking this random button for... Yeah, I think that'd be enough. We can start. So I'll see you guys loaded up in the game, and we can begin our adventures in Transport Fever now on a free custom map, on a European kind of type map, starting in 1950. Let's hopefully then start and build some of these kind of things, like the boats and the airplanes with the airports and whatnot. I think that's going to be just so fun, and you guys seem to be really liking it and want me to continue this as a series, so I definitely am, and I'm definitely enjoying my early coverage of this game, because I was having some doubts about this game, but this game, I really wanted to grow on me. Like, Train Fever could have grown on me, but I just didn't give it the chance, so this game I'm hopeful for. So I'll see you guys in the map. Right, guys, welcome into the map that has been generated for us. Now, let me give you a sense of the kind of scale we're working here. I've now zoomed out all the way, and as you can see here, when I turn around, you can see how huge this map is. You can see on this side there is the edge of the map, but if I go now and explore the rest of the map, you can see how huge it is. It's pretty damn big, and I don't think we're gonna. I think definitely an air, like air. I'm saying airport. I'm gonna have a bad habit of saying airport instead of airport. That's the thing that you guys know about me. Like, I have these kind of weird habits of saying particular things, and airport is a thing that I say instead of airport. But as I was trying to say, airports would be really nice on this map. Because, like, imagine living here in Petersfield, and you want to go all the way, I don't know, say to Corby. That's going to be a really good thing. I've noticed that some frame issues with like the biggest map, obviously, because this is huge. This is really massive, and whatnot. I think we should start somewhere around this kind of vicinity here, where it's kind of moderately flat, and we have this huge lake here to actually contend with, which is really, really nice. We have 20 million in the bank, which is nice, from our, like, I think we started, like, before in the campaign with 3 million. I really don't think that's enough. Obviously, we've started here now in 1950, which is really cool. So, I do believe we should have everything... Yes, we have everything unlocked, which is good. And we still don't have, like some of the really, really modern kind of stuff. But that should be fine. That's not going to be too much of a problem. I think we should start first with maybe trying to build up some sort of, just assess here what we actually have. So, like, if we start here somewhere in this kind of triangle here, Filton, Lincoln, and Weybridge. If we can start, like, around, and also Pontefract. If we could start with these kind of four cities and then kind of branch out, that would be really good. The thing I'm seeing right now straight away that I really want to do is I really want to build like a little ferry that kind of goes across here. Goes between Lincoln and Weybridge. But I've tested out building ferries and passengers don't really go on it straight away. So maybe we have to build up existing kind of lines and stuff within these cities first before passengers want to go out and venture to like further places. But I think a safe bet to do first would be to kind of connect up some of these industries. So what do we have here? We have a constructions plant. It requires stone and slag and produces construction material, which would be really good for the towns. So, okay, so this needs. Wait, that wasn't the one I just clicked on. So this one needs stone and slag. But what produces stone and slag? Which is that's the thing. That needs coal and iron and then produces slag. Okay, so this one produces slag. So I can already see here a little bit of a cargo, like freight line that could be possibly made between these two places. Possibly. Like, it would be cool to make like a train kind of link around here for, what's this? This is, okay, so that's a quarry and that produces stone. Ah, okay, oh, okay. So straight away I can see here where we can get the slag and where we can get the stone and the slag from. I can already see it. This is actually really, really good. So in a way, should we actually go for it? Should we go here and actually make a freight line first? I think with a horse cart and like maybe a truck or something, I don't think it's going to be enough. Maybe in the final result here, when we make construction materials, a truck into the city would be fine. I don't think a train link would be, unless we want to build like a passenger train link. But I think for now, I can see that happening. I can see that happening with a cargo freight kind of service here between this quarry. It stops off here at this steel mill, where it can get the slag as well, and then. What's this one? This one needs planks and steel, and I do believe that one makes steel. So in turn, we can make even a little terminal here. Okay, I'm seeing this right now. This is all like getting planned out in my head of what's actually going to be happening here. Plastic, but I don't know where I can get the plastic and stuff from. Anyway, that's for like a later time. Let's start off with like some simple stuff. Let's not overcomplicate it too much. Let's build ourselves a let's go on to freight here, because freight's going to be much easier to start off with. And then, so we'll build this little freight line, and then we'll go into like say Flinton or probably even Lincoln and maybe make some bus lines, start getting that up, you know, and whatnot. So how do we want to do this? I think here we let's see here, what do we have? Freight station, train station, freight. I think it can be a terminal one. I don't think it needs to be a pass-through one. This one here. Enable to align with terrain. Why is that? Oh, like that. Yeah, we could make something like that, right? That's all right. Nice little train terminal thing there. 160-meter platform. I think that's going to be fine. We can always extend it in the future. And you can see that there's like a track type for high speed and standard. I'm guessing that's for like passenger services and whatnot. A catenary. What's a catenary? Oh, electric. Oh, yeah, because we're in the 1950s. Okay, yeah, that's fine. We'll put it somewhere like here. That'd be fine. And then if I actually go into the road here, we can make like a little connection here. Something like that. Then that'd be all right. And what's cool with the roads is that you can add bus lanes to them. So you can know like, you can add a bus lane or a tram track or whatever, which is pretty cool. But for now, we're not doing that, so we're building ourselves a little freight line. So we have a freight station there. Then obviously it needs to come and pick up something here. So we'll build a little through station around here. So if I rotate with M and N, like something like that. And then connect up with a road. What's this road? I don't know what this road is. Small country road. Yeah, that's what I want. Oh, too much of a slope. Oh, no. Oh, the slope's too high. Right, let me... Oh my god, this the thing's disappeared here behind you. Let me just go here and let me try and build it coming out here. Yeah, perfect. There we go. So that's got then a connection there. And then, what does that produce? That produces, that needs steel. I'm not going to connect that one up yet because this one is still a little bit problematic because we need the plastic and the plank. So I'm only going to do one to here, I think. So if we do something like that. And then connect up with the road. Perfect. Now we can build our line, hopefully. We go back onto the rail tool. And we just want standard track. We don't want anything too fancy. So right now, if I actually put on my contours, I can see where I don't want to be building. I don't want to build through the hills. I want to build as flat as I can, really. And stay on price, which would be really good. Oh, Jesus. I built a little bridge. Oh, that's so cute. Oh my god, that's so much money. But it's so hilly. That's the problem. It's really... Like, what I should have done is, like... Oh, yeah, I see where I went wrong here. What I should have done is I should have made it come round here. Would have made a lot less. Oh, but I've wasted so much money now. That's the problem. You know what? I'm going to learn from my errors here and actually correct myself. Come on, delete. Right. So if we go back now to our thing. I want to go down. Yeah. Wait, why are we going? No, let's go back up. What the hell? Okay, there we go. I hate that you can't build it straight. Like, it's always curved. I don't know why. Or maybe I'm not Ah, okay. I think you need to hold control or something like that. Ooh, this is, might be a problem. Too much of a slope. Oh, wow. Is that really too much of a slope? Like, really? Right, let's... Jesus. Is it that much of a slope that you can't... Okay. We'll keep it like that for now. Anyway, to be honest, I want to have a line that kind of like... kind of goes up here, because if you think about it, that'll be like a line that branches off from the main kind of line here that goes here. But then in the future, it would be really... Wait, what the hell is happening here? I guess that's connected. Anyway, what I want to do now... So I want to... Oh, look at... I hate that it's using bridges. I really hate that it's doing that. Yeah, do that. Oh, yeah. Why didn't I do that? Oh, God. And then I'm trying to get... Oh, my God. And I'm going to have to do another... Perfect. Good. And that didn't connect up. Are you serious? Doesn't matter. We'll just realign it. There we go. And now there's too much of a slope. How is that too much of a slope? Man, this is one thing I hate about this game. Like, some of these kind of little... annoying kind of things that just make it just, yeah, so that can work, but that little area here where I was just trying to join up can't work. So I don't, oh, don't get that. That's actually quite tilting, I'm not gonna lie. So wait, we have steel, so we have, oh, we need, so here it produces slag. And it produces, it needs coal and it needs iron. And we've gotten a line here that goes here and makes, okay, so we're going to need coal and iron. So is there a coal and iron place somewhere around here? I'm not too sure. That's not. Didn't think of that, actually. Where can I get coal and iron from? These are pretty far places now, going, stretching out. Wow, this is crazy. I can't actually find anywhere where it produces coal, because I need for this place to produce slag, I need coal and iron. And right now, I don't know where to get coal and iron. Can I turn those off? And can I actually find, show hide list of towns, industries. Products. What do I need? I need iron and coal. Oh Jesus, that's far away. Oh my God, that's far away. That's ridiculously far away. There's some coal. That might actually do it. So that, there's a coal place here. Then where else is there? I need a iron place. Filton iron. Where's this? Oh, nice. Okay, that'll be cool. So I'm gonna essentially have to make a... It's gonna be quite expensive, but that'll be fine, actually. Let me make a medium country road. Let's make some country roads. Let's lift this up a bit. Oh god, no. Yeah, like that. There we go. Oh, and it. Oh, did it connect? Nice, good. So then now that's connected, we can like take coal from here all the way to. That's actually going to be quite long. Now that I've realized. Oh my god, that's going to be so long. Would it be better to just make a train line? I actually think it would have been better to just make a train line now, actually, to come to think of it. Probably. Would it be better to make a train line? I'm not too sure. Because then I would need to double track it, if you know what I mean. It can't work single track wise, because I'm going to have like two lines, essentially. You know what, for the time being, I'm going to... So steel is there. Steel's going to be fine. Okay, yeah, I'm going to have to connect this up by train. Because it's just too... Or, do you know what else I could do? I could connect it up by boat. And it can take it here. Oh, I like this, actually. Okay, yeah, let's do it by boat. I'm just thinking here, like, what would be the better. So we're gonna connect the ore up via truck, and I'm gonna make a little depot. So, let's do the thing first. Let's do the coal. So coal, we're gonna use first our like new thing now. We're going to use our boat. I'm going to make a harbour. If I can get this one. Yes, this is the one. And if I rotate it a little bit. Outside of navigable waters. Oh, no. Oh, okay. There we go. Perfect. Got myself a little dock. And then, essentially, all I need to do is connect it up via... via a road, I think. What other roads do we have here? I would just do a small country road. There we go. I hope this connects up, you know. I really do. And then we connect. This is absolutely crazy what I'm doing here. I hope this gamble pays off. If it doesn't, we're just going to have to revert to... Oh, I need to rotate it. If this doesn't work, I'm just going to have to revert to just doing passenger lines and stuff like that, because I'm just not really good at doing freight. That's really weird where the grass kind of covers up the road. But I think that should be fine. So we've gotten a... We've sort of gotten a... Let's just plop down a... let's plop down a depot. So we've just got that all sorted out. There we go. And we connect this up to... Whoa, why is it so curvy? What the hell? There we go. So we got that sorted, and then basically let's go onto the vehicles one, and we need a road depot, and we can put it here outside of Flinton, which shouldn't be too bad. Oh, we got an airplane unlocked. Nice. Then I think. We're going to need to put a truck station about here. There we go. and a truck station. Somewhere maybe here. I think somewhere around here should be fine. Oh god, no, no, I don't want that. I want, yeah, I want one of those. Press shift if you want to like micro rotate it. There you go. Right, so I think we have everything done. We can turn off this navigable waters now. And we can start hopefully building some... Oh yeah, we need to put down a depot for our train somewhere. We need to even build like somewhere where the thing comes out of actually. If I can actually find a place where I can, would be a good one. Let's get something going like here. And then put down a depot. There we go. And then have another bit of track that kind of branches out. Are you serious? Oh my god, these slope things are just so annoying. Oh god, no, 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 I don't want that there. I've too much, what do you, oh my god. Too much slope, too much slope. Oh my god, how is this too much slope? How is there too much slope? I'm gonna have to build basically. Oh, this is absolutely ridiculous. I can't connect a thing up here. This is absolutely ridiculous. Why is it doing that? Oh. I just want to connect it up. Yeah, look, that should be able to... What the hell? What the hell? Can we go down? Yeah, can we... Why is it sloping so much? Oh my god. Huh. Look where I had to connect it up and waste so much more money. Oh my god, these sloping things are just super... Oh, and that hasn't connected up. Oh, that's triggering me really badly now. This didn't even... Oh my god. After all of that, and it doesn't even bother to connect up properly. Oh, thank you. Right. Now let's build some lines, shall we? Hopefully, this will work. If this doesn't work, then I've just wasted 10 million. I've essentially just wasted 10 million. Like, yeah. Let's just think about that for a bit. Right, let's build a line. Let's go from a new line. Let's build the coal one here with the ship first. And that will take it here. And that's some very, very interesting pathing. I'm not even going to question that. and I think that's it for that. Then we can start buying some ships. Let's go to freight. So let's have a look here what we have. We have here the Zoroaster, which goes 20 kmh, carries 60. Oh, but this can only carry oil. Oh, okay, we need one for coal. I like the look of these ones, but they're oil tankers, I think. And then this one we can use for coal. This one we can use for coal. This one goes 30. And then you have this one, which is 1 million, which I don't think we're going to do. I'm tempted to... I think because we've used up so much money, but the thing is, you see here, this one has 100 capacity, this one has 50. We can buy two of these ones and have 100 capacity instead of buying one of those ones, which will, like, the two of these only cost about 300,000. So I think I'm going to buy two of these, and I'm going to set them to line one. and see how that goes. We could speed up time a little bit. Oh my god, boats. One thing that that there isn't, which I'm a little bit sad, is there's no water animation, so it's just a static boat going through some static water, really. But there you go. There's our first freight kind of boat service. Hopefully, this activates. I really do hope, because I hope this isn't too far away from this, or it might be. But do you know what I could do? Is I could terraform a bit. No, I can't terraform. Asset brush, track asset, smooth terrain, race terrain, lower terrain. Oh, I can't. Okay, I can't do that. Or do you know what I could do? If in case. You know what, actually, you know, to do safe, I think it's not going to work. This, I don't think the coal's going to reach this harbour. Do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to just give it a little. I'm going to give it a little truck station here. And then put a little truck station here. So I do believe you can do this. You can build a truck station to take things to a dock, I think. But we'll I'm testing out. There we go. Then if we put a little truck depot. There we go. And if we build a line... from here to here, and if we then buy some road vehicles, we want some freight. Okay, I'm guessing this all can do. I'm kind of digging the bends, you know. Let's do, should we do, oh, that's, it's not a lot of capacity, you know. That's the thing. It only has 8 capacity. But I'll buy two. I'll buy two of these Benzes. 1, 2. Set line 2. There we go. That should get some things going, and that should hopefully. I hope that gets the coal mine activated and going, you know. Are we really upset if it doesn't? And then that should hopefully help out the dock. That's what I'm hoping. I hope. Where is this going? These pathings for these ships is a bit interesting, I'm not gonna lie. Anyway, let's now build our other line, which we want to do, which is from the iron ore that we need to get. So if we do that, that to all the way to here, it's quite a long line, not gonna lie. Then if we go here to our depot, and let's buy, I'm tempted to just buy one of these, or buy one of these and one of these, and then set them to line 3. There we go. And that should hopefully get the iron ore mine in active use, I hope. Just time will tell, really, basically, with all of this. And then, essentially, we can get the train service kind of going between these 3 stops. So, let's build a line from here. That goes here. No. I didn't want 2 stops there. Remove. And 1... here. So essentially, if I close that, so that needs the rubble, the stone and the slag, and we're starting off by collecting the stone first from this place, then coming here, hopefully to get the slag, even though it does produce steel, even though I kind of just really want the slag. But then, for now, the train. This is going to be interesting for the train, because I think I can mix up the wagons that actually get transported on this train. So, if we... Oh, Jesus, the amount of trains. Jesus. Oh, wow. Look at these options. So, we have freight. Oh, so we don't have we do have electric. But, oh my god, they cost so much. I have to go with steam, right? How fast does this go? This goes 50. That's not bad. 50, 60. And that's all too expensive. I'm going to buy one of these, the Class 57 Prussian G3. So let's buy one of those. And for the wagons now, if we go on to freight, we want something that can carry stone and something that can carry slag, I do believe. So that can carry slag and stone, I think. Even though, I think I should just get the smallest wagons, to be honest. I don't think I need to spend too much on the newer stuff, because the newer stuff is so expensive. What's that? Livestock, plastic, machines, food, tool, goods, crude oil, iron stone. But look at that, 386,000 for a flipping carriage. Two of those, which would be 8, would still be cheaper than buying one of those here. Yeah, I'm going to buy like... 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do that. And set to line 4. There we go. I like how we have pantographs, but we don't have any electric trains yet. Does that have anything? No, it doesn't. That's a bit annoying. But is this working, though? No. Line. It should have a line usage. I don't know why it's not doing that. Let's fast forward time a little bit here. Because there is a line usage here. There is a line here waiting for... Yeah. So maybe it just hasn't started producing coal yet for some odd reason. See, that has a line usage, so that's working. Is this working? Yes, that's working. Good. And look at that, already it's starting to produce some nice rubble. I mean stone, I keep calling it rubble, I don't know why. But that's producing stone, which is good. Now, what is that producing? Well, this wouldn't be producing anything because it needs both of the things. Ah, but do you see this? Look at that. That's producing lovely iron ore. New vehicles available. Mercedes-Benz 06. Oh, look at that. It looks like some cool German locomotive. I still don't get why this one isn't working. Maybe it's... Oh, I don't know what... So that's a quarry there. Is there anything else I can take the coal to? Because I thought that you could essentially... Like, because what I want to do here is move the coal over to this side. But apparently you can't move it through two transport mediums. That's, I think, the problem here. Because I wanna move the coal to here so that the ship can... transport the coal, but I don't think it's close enough or whatnot to do it, because this coal thing's not working. It's not making any coal, which is a bit annoying, even though Like, I'm wasting so much money now on, like, the ship doing stuff. And, oh, do you know what? Okay, let's try this. Let's try this. I think I have a resurrection here. It's because maybe this thing here, this shipyard here, is so much, it's further away from this plant. So, basically, let's do this. Let's see if this works out. So, if I go here, if I make a thing here, and then make a new line that takes stuff from the dock here and takes it here to get to this plant. Hopefully, now, if I buy some road vehicles, go and freight here. Let's buy one for now. Let's see how that works out. Where is the thing? Set line to line 5. So you see what I've done here. I've essentially linked up this port with this factory over here. So hopefully now, this coal mine over here, wherever I started, hopefully now it recognizes that I've connected up this whole line for it to bring the coal. Yes, there we go. Look at that. Line usage, yes. I'm very happy about that because we would have wasted so much money. Oh, that is actually fantastic. I'm really happy about that. See, I'm figuring things out. Like, you know, I'm learning into this game. It's not like I know everything about this game. I'm, like, testing out things and whatnot. So let's just see it to believe it. That's 5 of 8 coal. Okay, let's slow down the game a little bit. So now, this is going to get populated with coal, which is really good. Okay, so line 1, waiting coal step. Nice. Okay, so this is all nicely connected up now. Oh, that's really good. I'm really happy about that. Okay. Wait, just a second. Oh, no. I'm just making things up. Yeah, look. Wait, but that coal just transported itself there by itself. Because I'm pretty sure that... Wait, let's just have a look at this. Okay, yeah. Okay, the coal's getting transported. That's nice. Okay, cool. So now, one thing I'm actually going to do, if I go here onto my line manager and actually have a look at, if I have a look at my ship line, one thing I can do is I can change how I want, so when the ships are here at Lincoln South, I can change how I want, if I want them to wait till the ship loads up. Or if I want to, if I want them to go at any kind of load if available. So here it says full load any, and there's full load all. I'm gonna go with full load any because then I want the ship to fill up and not waste money traveling across the lake and whatnot. If you know what I mean. I think that should do it. So you can see now, this is fantastic. I could just stand here now, watch this little like mini operation going on here, because we basically have an operation here. We have, once the ships do their thing, because right now they're very slow, but this one's coming back and it's going to get a nice juicy chunk of coal, and then that means that this plant essentially is ready to go. And the train, it's all good. And this is now producing stuff. Slag, stone. Wait, does that mean it produces either or? Right? Am I reading that correctly? So it needs either slag or stone. Oh, so I didn't even need to connect it up to the slag. Oh. Well, fantastic. Let's build. Let's go a little bit. Let's go beyond. Let's go build another truck station here.
and let's build a truck station into town. Let's actually quickly have a look. Okay, yeah. Oh, look at that. Perfect. The industry is right here. So if I now go and build another truck station and build it like right here into town, that's perfect. And then, oh, do I want to build another? Yeah, I'm gonna have to build another. I'm gonna have to build another thing. Where's the ship? Oh yeah, it's coming. I'm gonna have to build another depot because there's no road connection connecting to that depot I built in Filton. So I'm just gonna build one here if I can find my depots. There we go. And then we build another line. I'm gonna have to name these lines at some point because it's gonna get confusing. Let's buy two of these Benzes. Set to line 6. There we go. And that should hopefully start filling up with some construction tools. I hope. That would have been awkward if I just built a line for no apparent reason. That would have been very awkward. Oh, look at that. That's beautiful. At least the stone's working out nicely in my favor, so I'm happy about that. Now, let's have a look here. See how our coal is doing. While we wait for a ship to come. Speed up time a little bit. Because I do believe this will fill up now and go. Because I've changed it on the line manager for it to wait till it can fill up. If I remember. And how many is right here? 33. So I think it's gonna... I think. I'm not too sure. What did I put it on as? Full load any. Full load all. I'm going to do full load all. So it has to fill up to the max before it leaves. So at least it makes the maximum profit. You know what I mean? So things are making money. So we're making money. That's good. Let's slow down here and watch this fill up. I wonder where the hell, where does all of this go? Where does all the coal go? In the hole? I'm guessing in the hole. Because that's crazy if, it's just like all like that. Like it doesn't look like anything's actually filled up here. You know what? Let's buy another two and set to line. What? Oh, damn. What's the line here? That's line. It's line 2? Yeah, let's do line 2. So we just have a few more trucks to aid in the coal. I'm happy that operation's going. I was getting so worried that like this coal thing wasn't going to actually work out, but at least now enough coal's going to be hopefully produced. Hopefully enough will be produced to aid the shipping. Because right now we need to fill up. Look, this ship needs one more unit to fill up. And then when that other ship now comes, that ship's good. And I think that's good that I put that on. Because then at least, you know, 50 units need to fill up before it goes. And then once it gets over there to the other side, it's going to make a lot more money than if it was just, you know, coming here, picking up like a few crates and going over. That's just wasting a lot more money. If you know what I mean. So is this... Oh, this... Wait, that doesn't have anything. Does that have anything? Yes, that has some coal. Nice. Come on, coal plant. You need to make me some more coal here, man. Right. Let's see this this ship off. And there we go. 50 units of coal ready to go. With a few more to spare. And then we can fast forward the time a bit. That's good. I'm happy about that. It's actually really, really nice. And everything so far is making enough money. Line 5 isn't going to make any money because we haven't delivered any coal over there to that side. But once that gets onto the other side and brings loads of crates of coal, that's going to... Oh, that's going to make so much... that's going to make some really nice money. But as I said, I didn't realize that it was either or. So we only need stone to make the construction material, not the slag. But I've connected up a place to get slag anyway, so in a way I hit two birds with one stone here, to be honest. I think not bad. Definitely not bad, actually, to be honest. How's this doing? So this is basically packed up full of steel. I mean full of iron ore, and it's waiting for the coal to produce the slag, I do believe. But hell, I don't know. That's working over there. Those are working. That's all good. And then now this ship is here, and that's waiting. That's got 20. See, yeah, this is good. This is a good little system we have here going here. And it's just all good. I just hope that this this coal mill just starts... This coal mine, what am I saying? Mill. I hope it just starts making more coal, because right now it's very slow at producing the coal. But you can see here, we have another coal mine here. So we could possibly... start connecting, and look, you can see here there's a quarry, and look here, another place to make construction material. So that may be something for the next episode, where we start connecting up stuff to Ride, maybe, and even Escher. I've just basically been making a lot of freight lines and whatnot. I forget about the passenger service. This is just so cool, just connecting up like materials and stuff and industries, to be honest. But I promise in the next episode, we're going to definitely dwell into making some bus lines and some tram lines. And then hopefully some trains, train stations and stuff in the future. That'd be really cool to do. And one thing which would be even better to do, because right now we're just running on single track. It'd be really cool to double up the track so we can have multiple trains running on the same line. That would be my hopeful goal to do. I hope. But one thing that's going to be an interesting problem here is if this factory produces slag and slag starts building up at this station, but if the train's already picked up a full load of stone, how will that affect? That's what I'm thinking. I don't know. Those are all things to think about in the next episode, I presume. But so far, I'm really enjoying this. We've made good progress. Oh, what the hell? Why is that not making any money all of a sudden? What the hell? Oh, it's... the trains, they don't make money. Look, right now will make money once it drops that off. There, 401k. And you can see it's in the green now. So the train might need two trains to make it a bit better. But I think so far that's good. And we might need to double up the track, as I said. But other than that, that should be fine. And then if we now see... Just to confirm that everything's working out perfectly, if we wait for this coal to arrive and finally get distributed here to the factory, that would be really good, and that would just solidify that we've actually done everything right so far, and we're going to hopefully make some money. Jeez, this is on fast time. I'm on the fastest time here, and this ship is traveling so slow. Come on, we can do it. Come on. Man, the pathing as well is just a bit annoying. I've seen some other videos where people have just been complaining about the ships. The ships just... The pathing of the ships is just all wrong. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Nice. And look, the ships are now making money. And now line 5. Oh, look at that. It's going to be some nice juicy coal. And then the coal's going to get into the plant here. Oh my god, this is all just... I love when things just all connect together and they just start working like a well-fit organism. It's just perfect. And I think this is what's going to be really cool with this game. Ah, there we go. There we go. And now that's making... that. Look at that. It's making the nice juicy steel. And it's making... some very nice slag, I do believe. And then, oh, look at there. Some slag building up on the station. Now, this is the problem here, is does the train now pick up the slag as well? I'm not too sure. If actually, let's go to the line manager here. Let's have a look. Load if available. Because the problem is here at... Filton South, load if available, full load any. I don't know how that's going to work though with the train. Because you can see now, like, thank you that the train's actually coming through. You can see here the train's full. Yeah, look at that. It just ignores it. So either, because the quarry here is producing... oh my god, it's producing so much stone. Damn. We're going to either have to make another line and put another train for just the slag, because the slag's just going to build up there and it's not really going to get taken anywhere, to be honest. Unless we make another train line to somewhere where... like, we can make a train line that takes stuff here. But then we're going to need planks and stuff, so that gets a bit more complicated and whatnot. So you see what I mean? This is going to get into... oh yeah, and look at this. Look at that coal. Oh my god, everything's just running beautifully now. I'm really, really happy. Anyway, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this first look into a custom game that I'm doing on this really, really large map. It's going to be, I think, a very nice, lengthy series indeed. I hope you enjoyed it. I know we haven't done much, but I was just trying to get used to kind of things of doing, like, I didn't even dwell into the kind of passenger stuff yet. I've just been doing freight stuff, and I think this is good. I think I kind of started off nice here, making, you know, a little bit of a connection here between, you know, Lincoln and Filton and whatnot, delivering the stone to this place here where it's making construction stuff for the city here. And hopefully this city will now start to expand because it has the construction materials. The coal's nicely getting, you know, transported from here and there, which is really, really nice. And then we have more coal and stone here, which we can then expand to here for ride. So we have actually quite a lot of things to do here. And we haven't even gotten into the passenger stuff. Like, we have enough to do with the freight stuff to even not even care about the passenger stuff. But I know we're gonna get into the passenger stuff in the next episode. Hopefully, we're gonna do something in Lincoln or in Filton or in Pontefract. I'd love to do something in Weybridge and in Lincoln, so then hopefully we can build a ferry that shuttles people across the lake. I hope, because I tried it before in a test and it doesn't really work well when people don't want to travel between cities, but we'll see. Hope you guys enjoy this. The shoutouts again go to... I completely forgot and I don't have the list on my second screen. I think it was Morgan Burke and Callum... Callum's something O'Cameron stuff. I do apologize, it's not on my second stream, and if I tab out the recording will stop. So thank you for watching. Those were the shout outs from the beginning of the video that I've kind of sort of remembered. I'm not too sure, but I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope to see you in the next episode where we continue on this custom map here, this huge custom map. Take care, and I hope you enjoy my early access preview of this game, Transport Fever. See you guys next time. We ain't